Nearly 3 months have passed since Korea successfully launched its first space rocket, the Naro. But that is just the beginning, as the government has already launched its follow-up projects. Our Song Ji-sun brings us this special report from the Naro Space Center.
Things are business as usual here at Goheung, just as they were on the days that engineers were preparing for a launch.
South Korea has become the 11th country to join the space club after successfully launching the Naro rocket and placing a satellite into orbit on January 30th. Naro Space Center here at Goheung is undergoing some major transformations, preparing for its next project known as KSLV-2, or Korea Space Launch Vehicle No. 2.
The launch pad used by Naro 3 months ago is going through repairs and maintenance. The bottom of the launch pad is still rusted from the extremely high temperatures it underwent during Naro's takeoffs.
We are building a test launch site for the KSLV-2 right next to this launch pad. The whole space center will be equipped with new buildings and facilities needed for developing and testing the KSLV-2.
The KSLV-2 will use 4 75-ton engines, whereas the Naro had just one engine that weighed 30 tons. To accommodate the KSLV-2, the assembly complex needs to be rebuilt.
This is where we assembled the rocket's 3 stages. But due to the bigger size of the KSLV-2, this assembly complex will have to be expanded, and this assembly line will be used for testing the launch vehicles.
Of course, there were some who said that the Naro could not be called a complete domestic success, given that the first stage of the rocket was provided by Russian scientists. But the chief of the development team says it was a collaborative effort, one that was necessary for a giant leap.
We did obtain invaluable knowledge from them and worked our way up to emulating their technologies. In fact, we've also developed an engine identical to the ones used in Naro on our own, as we prepare to develop the next engine for the KSLV-2.
The Korea Aerospace Research Institute recently revealed its roadmap for the next 3 decades, called Space Vision 2040. Following the launch of KSLV-2, Seoul has set its eyes on sending a moon orbiter by the year 2020. By 2040, Korea aims to have sent an astronaut into space in a homegrown space shuttle. Developing the first stage of the KSLV-2 rocket is the first step to getting there.
We've also established our launch site and human resources who now know how to carry out these tasks. Our task now is procuring infrastructure for testing and developing the industries related to space science.
Song Ji-sun, Arirang News, Goheung.